Hey and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have 14 noteworthy updates to talk about this month. Let's start with some general updates. First up, we've launched Web Analytics. Web Analytics is a simple Google Analytics alternative, or a better way to track website traffic. It's privacy-friendly, cookie-free, and lightning-fast, and offers focused insights with just the metrics you need. See central metrics on a clean dashboard, with a historical performance graph to track top-level metrics. Top sources to see where your visitors are coming from and which pages drive the most organic traffic. And top traffic locations and devices to see which devices to optimize for. I'll leave a link to learn more in the description below. Next up, AI Content Helper is now multilingual. Our content score now supports 173 non-English languages and generates topics in the primary language of the SERP. Moving on to Site Explorer. In portfolios, you can now compare targets and see individual metrics with the new Targets List Overview widget and a standalone report in Site Explorer. Moving on, the Organic Pages by Traffic widget from a few years ago is back in Overview. Instead of the table version we've been using recently, we decided to restore the chart version we used in the past by looking at the amount of pages in each bucket and how much search traffic these pages are driving cumulatively. You can understand the SEO strategy of a website. Very visual, very shareable. Moving on. In the organic keywords and paid keywords reports, we've added filters so you can find valuable keywords that bring both organic and paid traffic, or focus on organic only or paid only keywords. Moving on to Keywords Explorer. We've added a 12-month growth forecast metric to Keywords Explorer's overview and tables. Forecasting is done by fitting statistical models with historical data. Use this to predict how keywords will trend in the future and zoom in on promising opportunities. Moving on to Site Audit. You can now ask AI to generate titles and meta descriptions right in the Patch It input box. Use this feature to draft titles and descriptions with a Pro Project Boost add-on, and publish patches in full with a Max Project Boost add-on. Moving on. Patches are now integrated with IndexNow. So when you patch a page to fix an issue, this change can be instantly auto-submitted to search engines and get indexed faster. Just enable this auto submit to index now section in crawl settings. Moving on to Rank Tracker. We're almost done with our Rank Tracker 2.0 revamp, so here's what's new. The share of voice and share of traffic value metrics are now available in Rank Tracker's dashboard, overview, and competitors overview. Use them to measure your brand's popularity and visibility across organic search and see how valuable your content is compared to existing organic competitors in the market landscape. Before, the competitors' pages and domains reports were sub-reports of traffic share. Now, we've made them more accessible right in the sidebar and added more metrics to them. Moving on. In competitors' overview, you'll now see history charts showing the general performance, positions ranking history, and owned sub features. Do deeper analysis with the competitors' table below. Moving on. We've added a no-rank filter in overview 2.0. that lets you quickly find the keywords that your target isn't currently ranking for. Moving on. In all GSE reports, you can now use this date picker to see changes across custom ranges. Moving on to our final update. We have a big batch update for API V3. Here's everything new. First, the organic competitors endpoint for Site Explorer is now available. It returns a list of competitors ranking in the top 10 for your keywords. There's also a new endpoint for total search volume history. You can use it to pull the total search volume history for all target keywords with the top positions parameter. Next, the organic keywords endpoint now includes two new fields which return the percentages of search volume from mobile and desktop devices. It also returns search intents. Lastly, we've released the competitors overview endpoint for Rank Tracker. It provides rankings and estimated traffic that your competitors receive from the keywords you track. I'll leave links to our API documentation below. As always, use the API buttons in individual reports to help you build request URLs. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Kenny. See you in the next update and have a great day.